After praising Allah and sending salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I advise all of you, including myself, to fear Allah as he should be feared. Dear brothers and sisters, we are in the great 10 days about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran, وَالْفَجْرُ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, by the time of Fajr and the 10 nights. So these are the 10 nights we are in. These are the nights of the Dhul-Hijjah, the 10 days of the Dhul-Hijjah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is great. And the great does not swear by anything which is great, except which is great. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed us that the great, in these great days, the actions of the human being is highly recommended, highly appreciated, much rewarded. And the reward is so great that no other reward can compare to this reward, except a person who goes out of his house for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his life and wealth, and he does not come back with anything. The meaning of that is except the martyred person, except the shaheed, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only that reward, the reward of that person is greater than the reward of these 10 days. And there is no other reward will take that place. And among these days, as you know, the Hujjaj, they all are going to the Hajj and gathering in Makkah al-Mukarramah, showing the unity of the Ummah. All the people, from the children of Adam, and Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was created from the mud, sand, from the turab. And there is no priority, there is no fadila, honor, a high place to anybody in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except with the taqwa. Whoever fears Allah most, whoever has the more consciousness of Allah, he will be more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the practical example of this is the Hajj, where everybody from all around the world stand behind the one Imam, praying in Masjid al-Haram, feet to feet, shoulder to shoulder, having no differences. And alhamdulillah, the people over there raising kalima of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have been commanded to raise the takbirat. As the ulama rahimahullah has mentioned this, in these 10 days you can raise the takbirat. And the takbirat, there are two kinds of takbirat. One is the general takbir, which you can say from the first day of the Hijjah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Wa lillahi alhamd. And tahmid and tahleel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, in these days is highly recommended. And the other sort of takbirat is starts from the day of Arafah. From the day, from the Salat al-Fajr, after the for salawat, you raise the kalimat, saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Wa lillahi alhamd. Even though we are not with the people of the Hajj present, physically present with them, but we are with them spiritually. We are with them in raising the kalima of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And moreover, in these days, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been described as one of the Sahabiya, Hanida bint Khalid radiallahu ta'ala anha. She says that few of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he used to fast these 9 days, the day of Zil Hijjah, the 9 days. And then the day of Arafah, he used to fast. Every month he used to fast 3 days, and every week 2 days. This was our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So another action which a human being can do in these 10 days to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is fasting. So if you fast in these days, you'll get more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama rahimahullah has the debate. They have said that which days are better? Are these 10 days are better? Or the days of Ramadan? So all the scholars said the days, in terms of day, the 10 days are better than the Ramadan, but the last 10 nights of Ramadan are better than these 10 days. So they have combined their saying like this, because the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said there's no action can take the place of these 10 days. No other ibadah, no other reward will take this place. So they have said these 10 days are better. So the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's recommended, it's not obligatory to fast in these days. But the day of Arafah, yes indeed, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whoever fasts on the day of Arafah, I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive for the person's previous year's sins and the future year's sins. Subhanallah, 2 years of sins will be forgiven by fasting the day of Arafah. And what is this day of Arafah? The day of Arafah is 9th of Dhul Hijjah, which will be inshallah on Thursday, one day before the Eid. This day, our religion has been made completed. Once one of the Jew person, he approached to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he said, he heard about the ayah, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Deenakum Wa Atmamtu Alaykum Ni'mati Wa Raditu Lakum Al-Islam Deena. Today I have completed upon you my favor, my deen. Today I have completed for you your deen, and I have completed my favor upon you, and I am pleased with you that you have the religion Islam. So I am pleased with Islam as a religion for you. This is the ayah of the Quran. When he heard this ayah, he said that if this ayah was revealed to the Jews, they would have made the day of celebration to that day. So at that day, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that I know when this ayah was revealed and what time it was revealed. It was revealed on the day of Arafah, the day of Jum'ah. It was the day of Jum'ah, and our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was on the back of the camel and he was making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that time, this ayah revealed, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Deenakum Wa Atmamtu Alaykum Ni'mati Wa Raditu Lakum Al-Islam Deena. So in this term, this day is really, really important day, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has completed the religion for us in this day. Not only that, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that khayr du'a du'a yawmi arfah. The best du'a a person can make, the du'a Allah will accept, it is the du'a of the day of Arafah. The best du'a is the du'a of the day of Arafah. Subhanallah, look at the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of Arafah, he was making the du'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama has said they counted the time from the time of the zawal till the sunset. It was around 6 hours and more that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam engaged himself making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the best dua which myself and other prophets has made, it was La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Subhanallah, if you look at the meaning of this, there is no dua. There is no dua in terms that you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is you are testifying that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it is the best dua? Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this. And he said, not only me, but the previous prophets, they also used to make this dua. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك والحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Subhanallah, the ulama rahimahullah has mentioned that if you ask somebody, just ask and ask and ask, the person will get fed up. The person will get fed up because always you are asking and asking. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is away from all kind of examples. But the ulama rahimahullah, just to explain to our brain, they said, if you praise a king, you don't ask anything, you just praise him. So always king give you more than what you expect. Because king has everything. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is away from the examples, he is Malik al-Muluk. He is the king of the kings. When you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you are asking. Not only that, many times we want to ask something from Allah and we don't know how to ask, but Allah knows our need. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give that one as well. Subhanallah, the best dua is the day of Arafah. We all must pay attention to the day. We all must ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that day. Subhanallah, who do not have the problems, who do not have the troubles in his house, in his society. Subhanallah, in every single level of the humanity, you will find the trouble. Individual level, family level, cultural level, your society, as a Muslim ummah, everywhere there are the problems. We don't know whose dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. And from whose dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the problem and the trouble of the ummah. So dear brothers, this day, the day of Arafah, is a great day. We all should make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For ourselves, for our family, for our children, for our parents, for our relatives, for our neighbors, for the Muslim ummah. And Muslim ummah, we should never forget. Subhanallah, I just remember one of the story of, as it has been mentioned in the books of tafsir, that Sulaiman alayhi salatu was salam, he was going to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for rain. And when he was going and he was taking his people, he told his people, "Oh people, get back. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you the rain." People said, "We didn't even start making the dua. We didn't pray for the rain. How come Allah will give us this rain?" Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, "I have seen," and this was the beauty of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah had given him the miracles. Then he said, "I have seen an ant, very small insect. It is raising the hands towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah for the rain." He said, "Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of this creature's dua, he will feed and drink all the people. He will provide the rain to everybody." Subhanallah, we don't know whose dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. And when he will accept, when the dua will come out from the sincere heart, and it goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and straight away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. So dear brothers, this day, the day of Arafah, don't forget making dua for the ummah. Yes, indeed, you make dua for yourself, for everybody, whoever you wishes. But don't forget the ummah of the Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have the mercy on this ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala combine this ummah upon the Quran and Sunnah. And this day, the day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants a person the best thing a person can imagine. The best thing a person can imagine. Subhanallah. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. As we know, the fadail of Umar, second khalifa of the ummah, he was on the bed of the death. A person came to him and he started praising him. He said, "Oh Amirul Mu'minin, you are this, you are that. Allah has done this in your hand. Allah has given you tawfiq. You have done this. You got the glad tidings of the Jannah in this world." And he was going on and on and on. What Umar radiallahu ta'ala said? He said, "Subhanallah, whatever you say, if it is true. But what I wish against this all, if Allah save me from the hellfire, and not even enter into the Jannah, if He save me from the hellfire, that is enough." Subhanallah, that is the wish a person would make. And that is the best wish. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, "فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ," whoever have been pushed away from the hellfire, kept away from the hellfire, وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ, and enter into paradise, فَقَدْ فَاسْ, he'll be the successful person. This is the deepest wish of every Muslim, and this should be the deepest wish of every Muslim, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save him from the hellfire. And in that day, the day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants the freedom from the hellfire to so many people that there is no other day Allah would do that. That is the day of Arafah. You are fasting at that day. You are raising hands to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. If you get that mercy of Allah, that you will be given forgiveness and you will be given the freedom from the hellfire, what else you want? I pray to Allah, Allah grant us the day of Arafah. And Allah set our necks free from the hellfire. Dear brothers, this was the day of Arafah. And at that day, when people will be raising hands and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the dua, subhanallah, when you go to the Hajj, you will see that as long as you can see, it is the sea of the people. All of them in two garments, white garments, and they are raising hands and they are crying and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will ask angels, why these people are there? What are they doing? Even though Allah knows about them. So the angels will say, Allah, they are your servants. They came to ask for forgiveness of yours. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feel proud at that time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feel proud in front of the angels and he will say, whatever these people are asking, I am granting them. Subhanallah, the day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feel proud because of the human beings asking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers, that is the day of Arafah. And after the day of Arafah, as you know, the day of Eid will come for all of us. And the day of Eid, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, that وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا, that for every nation we have made the day of celebration. The day of celebration where they slaughter an animal and read the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that. Subhanallah, every nation, all the previous nations had this day, that they had to slaughter animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do the Muslim Ummah have to do this, remembering the Sunnah of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhim salatu wasalam. If at that time, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam with the lamb, if it was not happened, the ulama rahimahullah has said that all the human beings had to slaughter a son for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their life. Subhanallah, Allah saved us from a great trial. From a great trial, oh Allah, without the trial except from us. From great trial, Allah saved us. And what Allah did? Having mercy on us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced with the animal. Subhanallah, this is the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Lot of virtues has been mentioned about giving the dhabiha. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said he never left the dhabiha, always he slaughtered the animal. And one lamb is enough for a family. One lamb is enough for a family, but people can give more if they want. And if they can't afford it, seven people can put a share in a cow or a camel, and then they can slaughter. This is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved the action on the day of the Nahr, the day of the Eid, and that is the slaughtering the animal. That action Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved most. Dear brothers, you live in a country. You cannot slaughter the animal at your home. You cannot slaughter with your own hands. There are rules and regulations. Nobody should break the rules and regulations. Islam does not allow you to break the rules and regulations. Yes, if you cannot do this, you can witness it. You can watch it. Subhanallah, take the time out. Go to the slaughterhouse and watch. They allow you to watch it. Yes, indeed, there is a ta'ab. There is an effort behind it. You have to put a lot of time to go there. You have to stand in the queue. Do this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, but teach your children as well. Remind them why we do this. What is the story behind it? That will create a great connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, every person should do the zabiha. At least one in this country. Just to remind the sunnah in ourselves and in our children. If you have more than one zabiha, yes indeed, ulama rahimahullah has permitted that you can give to some other country where Muslim brothers and sisters who are suffering, they can get benefit from it. But remember, this is not the sadaqah, as you give the charity and forget about it. No, this is your dhabiha. This is your dhabiha. When you are giving them, they are slaughtering behalf of you. So this is the dhabiha, this is not the sadaqah. At least one you should do over here to revive the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And if you have more than one, you, yes indeed, you can send to other places. But make sure who you are giving to, when they are going to slaughter. Because from the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, if you are going to slaughter the animal, You are not allowed to cut your hair in these 10 days. You are not allowed to cut your nails in these 10 days. So remember, this is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So after slaughtering the animal, you are allowed to cut your hair and nail. So what happens in this country, we do the Eid according to Makkah. But in other countries, they do according to their own moon sighting. So it might, one day might differ. So you do not do on the day of Eid, you do not cut your hair and your nail. You have to make sure where your qurban is going, where your animal is going, and when it will be slaughtered. If it is the next day, then next day you have to do this. Don't do before this, because it will be against the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dear brothers, these were the few sunnahs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the day of qurban, the day of Eid al-Adha. The day of Eid al-Adha, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that you come to the salat, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for Eid al-Fitr, you eat few dates and come to the masjid. But for Eid al-Adha, you don't eat anything and you come to the masjid. You pray and then you go. And the sunnah is to eat from the animal's flesh after slaughtering. But it will be really, really difficult. So you can eat anything, but eat after the Eid prayer. Because this is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكل سائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى من والاه أما بعد. Dear brothers, as you know the sunan of Eid, the Eid, the day of celebration, you should feel at celebration. You should make your children feel that it is the Eid, it is the day of celebration. Make sure you spend some extra money on your children to make them feel that this is the day of celebration. Yes, indeed, we live in minority. We are in minority, but it does not mean that we forget our Eid, our celebration. Yes, as a Muslim country, when there are Muslims are in majority, everybody can feel that that is the day of Eid. Everybody is feeling happiness. Everybody is congratulating each and other. People are conducting this and that. Subhanallah, this happens. But in this country, because of the minority, our children would not feel it. So make sure they feel it. You have to give time to them at that day. Take off from the school at that day. Make sure they enjoy that day. You give them the present so they will wait for the next Eid. Make sure. Because comparatively, when many other Eids or other celebrations of other nation comes, people know that. In schools they celebrate it. So make sure your children know about the Eid. So make it the day of celebration. And the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to come to the masjid. Before you come to the masjid, take the shower with the intention of the Eid. And then put the nicest clothes, put the perfume, come to the musalla. And when you are coming to the musalla, the place where you are going to pray, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to come walking. It is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come walking. Yes, indeed. I know that the masajid are very far from each other. The musallas are very far from each other. People live far distance. Make sure you come in your car to the and keep the car away from the masjid. And walk a little bit following the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And another sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you come from one street and go from another street. This is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And moreover, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam encourage our women to come and join the Salatul Eid, join the dua Imam makes at that day, listen to the khutbah. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even the women who are in their menstruation, they should come to the masjid. They should not join the salat, but they should listen to the khutbah and they should join the dua. This was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, subhanallah, look at how was the poverty at that time. People did not have proper clothes to cover their head properly. So they have complained to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one woman should cover in his clothes to her sister as well. So they both will cover and they come to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This shows the importance of bringing the women to the masjid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given to the extent. So we should bring our women and children to the masjid on the day of Eid. Make them feel that that is the day of the Eid. These were the few sunnah of the day of the Eid. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts to accept the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the truth as the truth. As the truth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ability to act accordingly, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows the false as the false, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of us away from the evil. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Ibadallah rahimani wa rahimakumullah. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsani ويزايد القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيدكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم. على ذكر الله يذكركم. السلام عليكم.